Christians all across the world are overjoyed that Iran has finally released four American prisoners. But some say that President Obama gave away too much to get them back.
The former prisoners have been getting medical checkups in Germany before they return to the United States to start their lives again. And that won't be easy for any of them. Gary Lane has the story.
During an interview with a TV station in Boise, Idaho, Nagme Abedini called her husband Saeed's release surreal and unbelievable. She said it will take time to adapt once her husband Saeed returns home.
It will take time to readjust, to know each other. I'm a different person, he's a different person. I don't know where he's at physically, mentally, and our family would need time to readjust, and that's going to be the next step and asking for prayer.
But some Republican presidential candidates criticized the deal that set the Americans free from prison, saying it set a bad precedent.
It proves, once again, that now nations and enemies of America around the world know that there's a price for Americans. If you take an American hostage, Barack Obama will cut a deal for with you.
And Donald Trump said, quote, "We give them $150 billion. We give them essentially 22 people, 21, 22 people. But these are people that really did have problems, and we're getting back four people who didn't do anything wrong. That's the way we negotiate. That's the way we negotiate. It's so sad. It's so sad." President Obama said the prisoner deal and the nuclear agreement with Iran serve as a reminder of what America can achieve when it leads with strength and wisdom. But the president's positive spin on the deals is unlikely to change attitudes toward Iran in the near future. Many Americans still distrust Iran and think the nuclear agreement was a bad deal. But for now, the captive Americans are heading home. Gary Lane, CBN News.
In other news, Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump is keeping up his efforts to attract evangelical voters. John Jessup has that story from our CBN News Bureau in Washington. John?
Thanks, Gordon. As part of that strategy, Trump took his campaign message to Liberty University Monday. David Brody was there and brings us the story from Lynchburg, Virginia.
Right off the bat, Donald Trump tried to relate to his Christian audience, even if it didn't come out exactly right.
2 Corinthians 3:17, that's the whole ballgame. Where the Spirit of the Lord, right? Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
And he didn't stop with scripture.
We're going to protect Christianity, and I can say that. I don't have to be politically correct.
Despite a lack of evangelical-type accomplishments, some students here seem to like Trump's outsider feel.
He's kind of a hothead. He says what he wants to say, but he's politically incorrect, and I think that's a lot about sometimes what we need.
In the competition over this crucial voting block, Ted Cruz is trying to paint Trump as a guy who doesn't have much in common with evangelicals. Trump told CBN News, however, why he should be the last man standing.
Ronald Reagan wasn't he didn't read the Bible every day, 7 days a week, but he was a great president, and he was a great president for Christianity. And frankly, I would say that I will be a far better leader.
And he adds, a good guy too, despite what you read in the headlines.
I think I'm a much nicer person than the public understands.
And he says that heart extends to Israel.
So I will back Israel. We have a president that I think is the worst thing that's ever happened to Israel.
Donald Trump is going to need a sizable chunk of evangelicals to secure the Republican nomination. And he'll get another opportunity to do just that when he talks to students and sits down with Pat Robertson at Regent University next month. David Brody, CBN News, at Liberty University in Lynchburg, Virginia.
Thanks, David. And you can see much more of the interview with Donald Trump on David's blog, The Brody File, on cbnnews.com. The number of Jews migrating from Western Europe to Israel has reached an all-time high. Jews are leaving Europe because of the rising number of anti-Semitic attacks. The nonprofit Jewish Agency says the vast majority came from France, which has the world's third largest population of Jews. And Gordon, experts say European Jews haven't felt this threatened since World War II.
The good news is that there's an Israel for them to go to. That is the good news in the face of rising anti-Semitism. And it's not just in Europe. The FBI tracks hate crimes here in America. And it's a shocking statistic. You would think for religious bias, there would be target against Muslims. Those are 15%. Targeted attacks against Jews just because of religious belief, just because of their religion, 60% of hate crimes in America for religious intolerance are directed at Jews. So it's wonderful that there's an Israel that they can go to. There's a place where they can be safe and be able to worship God as they see fit. That's wonderful news. And that is a good news to stand with Israel.